Okay. So I think it's working now. There we go. Nope. Nope, you still don't like that, do you? Alright. Alright, so today we're going to be making a giant LED strip. With 8 or 16 LEDs in conjunction with a SN74HC595N chip. So it's going to have 5 leads coming out of it, and it's going to be controlling up to 16 LEDs, if not more. I'm going to make the ability to plug it in somewhere and have a giant chain of them. So let's start a new project. Woo. File, new project. We're gonna do LED strip. Okay, so we're gonna go into library. We're gonna get the chip first. CN. Hey, there we go. That's actually the correct chip. We're gonna have 2 of these chips. And these chips are going to hook up to an Arduino somewhere. Just not right now. We're gonna use... Nope, not these. I think it was 4. Oh, we're gonna do that, and we're going to do. It's gonna use 330 ohms. So these chips, I'll have a. Let's just hook up what's similar. VCC. Ground. We're gonna pull everything this way that's not LED related. LEDs on the left, everything else on the right. So we're gonna have five pins coming out. Alright, so one of these is VCC. This one's ground. Now there's gonna be a serial in. And then the serial goes in through all the, so how this works is the signal goes in through serial. Either set as high or low, then the clock gets hit from low to high. Whenever that changes from low to high, it advances it from the serial to the next LED in order from 0 to 7. 0 is A, B, or 0 is A, then 1 is B, followed in all the way down to H. So those are the LED hookups. That's the easy part. And then once it hits, and so it progresses down the line. So with every clock speed, or with every clock up and down, the signal from A goes to, oh, right now, A would go to B. So if A is 1, then the clock hits, then B is now 1. And then if B is 1, C, D, and if cascades all the way down to H, then it goes to this QH. And after it hits QH on this side, it'll eject out as a serial. So I need to connect that to the next serial. So the serials on both of these chips are good. Alright, next would be... Oh, nope. Following someone else's design. Off of this, so I don't... Alright. So we got VCC. This one's QA is LED, so I don't want to touch that yet. Serial is taken care of. The OE is output enable. Okay, when the voltage is high, the output pins are disabled. Set high impedance state, won't allow current to flow. So what this is, the you want to connect this to, wow, I've already no, okay, so serial there. There, so I want this to always, okay, so if it's high, the LEDs won't light up at all. So I want to ground that. Same thing here. Next is the R clock. This is the latch. So none of these LEDs, the data from the serial is sent, well, with the help of the clock. Which one? A shift register. With this clock. Okay, so SR clock. Okay. So, okay, so the SR clock is the timer clock. SR clock. Okay, so the SR clock is the timer clock where you change 0 to a 1 and the data shifts from the serial to the next one and so on and so forth, cascading down and then going out of the chip and cascading down all the way through there. That's fine. The next... So these hook up to each other. And you're there. the R clock is the latch. The latch is basically the data has been cycled through, but the LEDs don't change unless the R clock is turned from low to high. So that needs a pin. Ooh. Ooh, wait, no. Yeah, and the SR clock needs a pin too. All right. So, and then the SR, the serial clear, a shift register clear, this pin makes all the bits zero at once, so all the LEDs or everything here would be zero. This is only when you want to reset it. I don't think I want to ever reset it. So it needs to remain high all the time. So we need to connect that. To VCC. I can just reset it by sending zeros again and again, and just that can be the first thing that I do when I program this thing. Right now, okay, so output. I also want to have a okay, that's there. We're going to do another 5. Oh no, wait, no. This is input. What I want is to create an output. So, basically, just copy everything from here. Ground. VCC ground. 3 is serial. Nope. Serial is going to be by this out. And then we can set 4 up with 4. And 5 up with 5. Nope. 5 up with 5. And so now, hopefully, it's got a clock out. Okay, so now I can plug two of these. Two of these are going to work together, and then I can have the same module connect to itself, and we're all good. All right, now LEDs. LEDs are going to be the hard things. No, they're not. Flip this. How do I flip it? Flip horizontal. There we go. There we go. And we got the LEDs. Okay, so we need 8 of them per thing. And you can actually shift that one. Shift this up here. 13. There we go. Okay, and all of these. Gonna get attached to ground. All right, there we go. And then, okay, and then this is gonna be easy. Said than done. Each one of these is gonna be individually attached pin. Pin. And then 9 goes up, around, and down. Go. Shift register. All right. I love shift registers. That's what these are. They just shift. Oh, it's in the name. They shift what you register it down one when the clock hits. So, yep. 1 becomes 2, 2 becomes 3, 3 becomes 4, and so on and so forth until you reach the bottom. We're going to name it strip. And we're going to try and make this as thin as possible. For whatever reason, I challenge myself on that. So it can be like a little strip that goes down. So that's saved. Now we can export. Convert to PCB. Cool, apply. Alright, so this is gonna be okay. I'm not gonna care about this so far. Okay, so 1 and 1. I gotta figure out. Nope, got it. Turn it that way. Control Z. Nope. Oh. Nope. Circuit keys, and we're going to be line top. Control Shift O. How do I do middle? Control H and E. H E. What? Oh, Alt H and Alt E, okay. Okay, so it's H I want. Alright, so that means I can just throw these all together. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Oh, they just, you know. Take this out real quick. And this. Do all this. We're gonna rotate these all to the there. U. Distribute horizontally. Cool. And oh nope. Distribute horizontally and then Control E. No, Control Shift H E. No, Control Z on that one. Horizontal center them. Okay, so where's two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, oh, come on, 10, 11, 12, 13. Go and put 16 at the end. Then this, and then distribute evenly. And then line center. Line center. Distribute evenly. And that looks about right. We're gonna put this on the bottom. And this one on the bottom as well. So this can open for a little more leeway on that. Yeah, those aren't gonna work. rotate this one that way and that way, and you're going to be on the other side. That there, move that there. Move that there. Move that there, I guess. Now we're gonna do this. Oh, come on. Do that. Oh man. We're gonna do line horizontally, space them out evenly, and then we're gonna, oh nope, delete the box that it came in and border outline on this, and we're gonna do, I want to make it okay, so one, two, one, two. Nope, control. Two. And we're just gonna save this. And we're gonna try. AutoRouter. Check trace with calculator. And, oh man, what's the chip? We're gonna go with 2 amps right there. And we're just gonna put 1. And run. I didn't get a call. Okay, screw this. I'm gonna do it myself. 2 amps. We're gonna put 5 amps through this. With a thickness of 1. So 2.77. Stop router. We're just gonna do it ourselves. No. You know what? No. Control Z. I'm not gonna. Okay, so how much does this chip actually use? Okay, so this uses input 20. It's the total. ESD rating, voltage, supply voltage. What's the... Alright, I'm gonna have to mute this for a second. Okay, so I'm back. That was my school telling me I don't have work tomorrow. So that's fun. Come on. Okay, so it gives me all the pinouts. I like the 20 pin. That I like this one better because NC, yeah. No connection. Voltage I. Max. Okay, so -160 microamps. So it's basically nothing. I really don't wanna. OSHA just tell you the max amount of amperage it could possibly. Just got the call. This one doesn't. Just a bunch of Andor gates. Applications, yeah. Let's see. Okay. Input clamp current, continuous current is that. Continuous current through VCC. Okay, so 70 milliamps. LED. How much amps does an LED use? This is freaking stupid. I should know how much. Oh, that's light bulbs. Does an LED draw? Okay. Segment of a 3 LED draws. Twenty milliamps. All right. Alright, so it draws 20 milliamps. So So 20 times 8 equals 160. Plus, we're going to do the 70 continuous. Plus 70 for continuous equals 230 milliamps. That does not seem right. That does seem right, actually. So, it's not even an amp. Yeah, okay, we're just gonna say it's not even an amp. Okay, so now that that's done, we can go back to the drawing. We can go back to, oh man, trace with calculator. PCB, we're going to throw in, so it's 230 or something, 230 milliamps, and I want that one, we're going to do 250 because of loss of power, so we're going to make it 1 amp. We're going to change this to millimeters. We're going to change this one to millimeters. We're going to go 2. 2 amps. Yeah, so we can have like 8 of them or something connected. So no. To printed circuits. You know what? Let's just. Oh, 2 is the problem. That's what we're having the problem with. Okay. Something wrong with that one. Play changes settings. Okay, that's good. This. Oh shit. Okay, so yeah, no. Control Z. Yeah, we got to do that. Okay, so there. Okay, so this. I can make this a bit bigger if I wanted to. We're gonna go for 2, actually, on this one. No. So, can I do 2? What? You're not gonna... What? Two. All right, there we go. Okay. Wait, no. Forgot to flip that one. So dumb. All right, now. Yes. Mm-hmm. point A to point B. Okay, so this should give me enough. Ooh. All right, let's just work on this one first. Okay, so now I got to change it to that. Okay. And now I can do. Wait. Okay, these things only need not even an amp of current, so I can go 0.3. I can make them even smaller. Okay, so this one 0.3. Same thing, but and then I go top layer. Oh. Where's this one go? Okay, so three should be serial. What? Mixed up the two. No. I got this one almost all wired up too. Nope, gotta delete it all the way. I can go forward. Darn it. Okay, so this needs to go there. This needs to go. Okay, you get the heck out of here. Okay. And you need to turn. Sit here. So I still need to
clinical trials. Pharmaceutical company shutting me down.
You're kidding. Really?
How could that surprise you? You sent them an email complaining about my math, telling them about your stunt.
I don't know. People actually read emails. Delete button so conveniently located.
So what's next? You gonna follow me my whole life? Torture me?
Why would I do that?
You waited 20 years to do this. What's next? Break up my marriage?
No. We're even.
Right. Oh, thanks for setting me up.
Eye for an eye, LSD and antidepressants. Everything in balance. Buddhists call it karma, Christians call it the golden rule, Jews call it, I don't know, Rabbi Hillel said something poignant. Universe always settles the score.
Does it?
No. It should. Think you'll ever be able to look at him and not blame me?
Yeah. Will you? I'm Paula. How you doing? You work over at the college, or are you full-time over at the...
I'm looking for a distraction. You don't need to talk to do that, do you?
Come on. I need to go there.
Call it great.
All right, so check the NRC. Yep, they're good. Yes, check it once more, and then, cool. I get these for 10 of them. Oh, let's see if we can do 20 of them. That's not bad, actually, for $11. All right. So I'm going to put the order in for that. What do we do, 50? That's not bad. Okay, so I do want to do 20. And that's about it. Yep. So, okay. So I just finished mocking up all the rails, all the traces and stuff. So that way it's the right... That way they're the right, they can handle the amperage correctly. There we go. Alright, yep. Alright, so all the traces can be handled, the amperage correctly, voltage, and they're all worked out. Okay, none of them are overlapping. Which is what DNRC errors are, DRC errors, DRC errors, and there's none of them. And I can order it for whenever. So the way I'm going to use this is I'm going to line up a bunch of them in series, one after another, and I can have a bunch of lights just going on and off, 8 to a thing. Could even do RGB if I wanted to, but yeah. So, yep. That's it. Here we go. Wait, it's 8. Oh, man, I need 9. Well, anywho, this is, just finished it. So, see y'all later. I'm going to order this now. I'm going to order a bunch of the other stuff that I've been doing. And then when I have them in, I'll build it. All right. See y'all later. Bye.